Yeah, sure. What is your thoughts on the APRs in Michigan, statewide?
That's probably the number one question other than CWD I get asked nowadays. I'm going to give you a long start back. We were North American Whitetail, and Steve Vaughn and I were instrumental in the early days of developing APRs, and not that we were the guys that developed it, but we financially supported the research done by Micah Goldstein in Dooley County, Georgia. And that was a remarkable work, and it was very, very successful. And that has grown over the years. It gave rise to the Quality Deer Management Association, part of the reason. But I have some very strong feelings about APR. First of all, the average deer hunter sees a deer for 3 seconds. Deer, buck, boom. That's just the way it is, you know. And we've had deer to hunt for over 70 years now, plenty of deer to hunt. And guys need to get over the days of just shooting antlers. The state agencies haven't gotten over that. They've practiced what we call traditional deer management. As a matter of fact, I was reading some of their old documents way back there in the 50s, and essentially saying that their goal was essentially to produce yard on buck and produce bucks for hunters to shoot. Now, many criticisms of APR, but one of them is that all it is trophy management. Well, it may be that's one of the side benefits is bigger bucks, but as a biologist, somebody who's been doing this for 50 years, I'm committed to managing for natural deer herds. And natural deer herds are those that have a natural sex ratio and a natural age structure living in a good habitat. I've meant for the majority of bucks that breed to be 4.5, 5.5 years old. And there are states out there where a 4.5 year, 5.5 year old buck exists. So I was very interested in the beginning to support people like that we could protect the yearling bucks. Now, there's lots of ways to do it. Some of them I've tacitly supported over the years because it's better than nothing. Point restrictions are the worst, because as our landmark study on antler growth and deer showed, that a yearling buck can be an eight-pointer, mm-hmm. or it can be a spotter, you know? So it's real difficult. The flexibility of points is not very good, but like in Arkansas, when they did the 6-point rule, I supported it because it was better than nothing. Biologically, we found that spread for most deer in the United States is a pretty good indicator. 15 inches, most of the deer in the United States are very happy to hold their ears at about 15 inches for you. But that creates a problem because the criticism we get all the time is that, well, what about the narrow deer, the exceptionally narrow deer? All you're doing is protecting those, and you're going to make your deer have smaller spreads. Well, in some cases, that's true. And on private hunting clubs or landowners that really ask me what's the best criterion for protecting young bucks, I tell them a 15-inch spread or an 18-inch beam. If you do that, you're going to protect everything, but you'll start harvesting some 3-year-olds, and then you'll get some 4-year-olds in the harvest that way. But the thing that I've learned all along, and we see from day one in Dooley County, is that APRs are only successful when it's a grassroots movement. State agencies dictating it will never work. People don't like state agencies to dictate to them about anything, so they don't work very well. It has to be a highly acceptable thing. Has to be the people have to want it. If they don't want it, I say, well, go for it. If you enjoy the low quality you got, well, then go ahead and wallow in it. But I'm not telling you what you have to kill. Those of you that are from Wisconsin, when I was the deer czar there, one of the big rubs was Ernabuck. Well, Ernabuck came from Clinton Lake, Illinois. A friend of mine was the one who came up with that. It's a power plant lake herd, and they had hunting only because of the power plant. And they wanted to have better bucks. he set a rule that he had to shoot a doe before he could kill a buck. Well, that's private land.
Yep. Right?
There's no doubt some of the data shows that earn a buck in Wisconsin worked pretty good.
Yeah.
It just made everybody mad. Just made everybody mad. And if he's mad and not supporting you, then why have something? You know?
Yeah.
So that's a long answer about APRs. I'm for them if the people want them. But if you're going to have them, make them very simple. You can't, you know, game laws have become so complex that you have to carry a lawyer around with you. You know, the rules should be very simple, especially young people. You know, they make it so hard for kids to get into hunting nowadays. It's so no wonder we're hunters right and left. So right. You have to make it simple. That's why I go for a 15-inch spread.